As the demand for greater efficiency, unmanned running and even lights out production increases for manufacturers, XYZ are responding by offering products that fix these problems for manufacturers. And one of those solutions is the XYZ 65 LTY-S, a sub-spindle lathe that has motorised spindles on main and sub, a 12-station driven tool turret offering 380mm max turning diameter and 520 max turning length. This box section slideway machine allows users to produce the parts in one hit so that the main and the sub can produce the features on both ends of the part. So with all the technology that's packed inside this machine, giving users the ability to turn, mill, drill, tap, making parts has become more efficient. But that'll mean that you churn more parts out. So one of the key elements of a turning centre is being able to feed raw material into it. So for a number of years, we've been supplying LNS bar feeds on our machines to keep that raw material being fed into the main spindle. And we're joined today by Tony Faccini from LNS UK to come and talk to us about why bar feeds are so important on turning centres. So, because we've been supplying these bar feeds for a number of years, Tony, what are the key elements that customers are seeing when they fit a bar feed to a turning centre?
Well, one thing that happens, Mike, normally the bar feed gets overlooked when purchasing the turning centre, but it's an integral part of the kit. So what we can do with a short magazine bar feeder, that allows us to run unmanned, it gives us overnight production.
Okay, and you mentioned their short magazine, but you'd also do long series bar feeds as well.
Yeah, that's correct. We have a various selection of long magazine bar feeds over various different lengths of bar, and we also have short lengths that we'll be speaking about today.
So we can satisfy customers' criteria in terms of how much floor space they have, in terms of how much bar length they want to utilise.
Yeah, that's absolutely correct. I mean, different customers, horses for courses, different customers. Some prefer the long bars, which come in 3 or 4 metre lengths. Others like to cut that in half down to 1 metre length. And this is where the Quickload Servo 65 comes into its own.
So you mentioned there, Tony, this Quickload Servo 65 bar feed that we've got connected to our LTY-S. You launched this to the public at our recent 40th anniversary open days down here in Devon. So was there a lot of interest in this product?
Yeah, we did, Mike. It was very, very busy. We had a great lot of interest. People come to see the new innovations and technology that we offer from our previous bar feed to this new one we got now.
So, this gives us a chance then. Let's drive down and have a look at what you've changed on this bar feed system to see that customers can increase their efficiency and production of parts. So there's been a number of changes on this Quickload Servo 65, Tony, compared to your legacy products. What's one of the major changes that you've seen on this product?
The major change, Mike, on this product is the fact that it's fully electric. There is no need for any compressed air anymore. That is one of the major benefits. So now this is a fully servo-driven bar feed and a fully electric bar feed.
So that means that for customers then, they don't need so many services to run this machine.
Exactly, Mike.
One of the things about our products, Tony, is that we have different headstock lengths on our lathes from the CT65 right up to the 320 LTY models. Is it a one size fits all with this Servo 65 bar feed?
That's a good question, Mike, because it's overlooked a lot of the time, if I'm being honest, because we do two different lengths of this short magazine bar feed. So we can load up to, the bigger version is a 1.6 length bar, and then the smaller version you can load up to 1.3 in length. But you're determined by your spindle length.
So again, we can offer the right bar feed for the customer's product that he's bought from XYZ and the shop floor space that he has available to fit a bar feed to his machine.
That's correct. If a customer wishes to load longer bar than his actual spindle length, what we do, we supply an additional part of equipment, which is called the bar support unit, which is an extension of the spindle.
So one thing that intrigues me, Tony, is a number of years ago we worked very closely with Siemens and the bar feed suppliers to develop cycles in our machine to make programming of a bar feed very simple and very easy. And we gave users the option to either feed to a stop, a station on the turret, or just feed out using the servo mechanism. So this new Quickload 65, can we use both facilities or is it just limited to servo operation only?
No, like you say, Mike, there's a lot of customers out there at the moment who've only got the old pneumatic bar feed, so they have to use the stop. But with this Quickload Servo 65, we can do both. We can either still use it to feed to a stop, okay, with a nice steady push out, or the benefits are we can use the servo to feed out to an actual length.
Ah, so that gives advantages to people that may want to fit this after they've had their machine a number of years, that they can still use both systems.
Yeah, that's correct.
I think over the years, Tony, one thing that's put people off purchasing a Barfeed to go with their XYZ turning centre is the fact that they don't actually do massive batch sizes. So although they do a reasonable quantity, they struggle to justify buying the Barfeed, and one of the reasons for that is changing over the different bar sizes they use. So how does this Quickload 65 now make that easier?
Yeah, this for me is one of the biggest advantages of this Barfeed. We've gone away from the mechanical changeovers. So the only mechanical changeover that you will make when you're changing your bar sizes is possibly the pusher size. But this bar feed comes with three different size pushers. Everything else that you see is done through two changes on the handset, and that will be the bar diameter and that will be the bar length. And that automatically changes loading fingers, channel height, and all your torque settings.
Oh, so it's taken a lot of the setting up that we used to do on your older product away from the operator. It's done using modern technology.
Exactly. If the customer was to change over and use the same size pusher, it will literally take a matter of a couple of seconds to change the two settings on our new touchscreen handset.
Okay. And that leads me on to another thing that I've just thought about here, is obviously different bar sizes. We need spindle liners so you don't get whipping of the bar in that spindle. I'm presuming LNS UK can supply the bar line, the spindle liners for the different size bars that your customer uses.
Yeah, that's correct. Part of the package when you buy a bar for you will be either two dedicated liners or one master liner. Now, to take these liners out is very, very simple. It literally is just a step away. You just press down on the pedal and the bar for you will retract as easy as anything on either in Z axis or in X axis.
So with the technology that we've got in this 65 LTY-S product, the sub-spindle, Siemens have developed within their transfer cycle of moving the part from main to sub, the ability to draw the bar through. So with this Quickload 65 servo, can we handle the fact that we can draw material through the main spindle with the sub-spindle itself?
Yes, LNS have developed something within their software where we can select what's called the sub-spindle mode. So with the sub-spindle mode, this saves a little bit of time where you're not relying and waiting for the push rod to feed out with the bar. So you're allowing the 65 LTY-S sub-spindle to do all the work. So the bar feed's function is purely to load a new bar into position. Once he's loading a new bar into position, the sub-spindle then takes over. The bar feed will then just count down the number of components it needs until it gets down to zero counts. When it gets to a zero count, it loads a new bar into the top cut, comes back to home position, and it doesn't move until it's asked to load a new bar again.
So it's another way, by combining the bar feed and the XYZ lathe here, to increase efficiency.
Exactly, it's a fantastic tie-in option.
So it looks, Tony, like adding a bar feed to one of the XYZ turning centres looks a great way of increasing efficiency and increasing your production. With machines that have got both 66 and 80 millimetre bar capacity in our range, can LNS support both of those types of bar capacities?
Yeah, they can, Mike. So we've been talking about the Quickload Servo 65, so that goes anywhere between 6 millimetres up to 65 millimetres. For bigger capacity spindles that you sell, we can go up to 105 millimetres with our Quickload Servo 105.
Okay. And so just to get an understanding of how long installation is, what do you get with your bar feed and how long to install?
Yeah, so the package with yourselves includes two dedicated spindle liners or a master spindle liner. It comes with three separate pushers. That includes installation and includes a full training package on the bar feed.
Okay, and I believe that we try to make sure that we're always on site at XYZ at the same time as LNS to make sure that the integration between the two components works seamlessly.
That's right, so our goal is obviously customer satisfaction. Okay, so we aim to be at the back end of your commissioning of the machine when we're installing the bar feed. So there is that tie between XYZ and LNS.
That's great. So if you'd like to know more information about XYZ's turning center range, tied up with an LNS bar feed to increase efficiency and production, and even offer you unmanned and lights out production, contact XYZ with the details that you can see on the screen, or contact us to arrange a demonstration at one of our showrooms all around the country. Thanks, Tony, for sharing your experience with us, and we look forward to seeing you again soon.
Thanks for inviting us, Mike.